from Fox 31 News, this is Good Day Colorado.
Now we're going to move on to a subject that most men don't want to talk about, let alone think about. And so, of course, we turn to Dr. John because he can kind of delicately work his way through this. But this is a problem for a lot of guys.
It is. And it's a problem called gynecomastia, which is the common vernacular, the basically common word for it is man boobs.
Sure.
And so this is basically, we're talking about a patient underwent the surgery, and it's a surgery that's done right here in Denver to help get rid of that. And it's a lot more common than you think it is. But here's some video on what happened.
Last month, we took you inside an operating room to show you a relatively new technology called VASER liposuction. Here it shaped a woman's abdomen with much quicker recovery time than traditional liposuction. You've also seen how it can lift a woman's breasts without implants. But this revolutionary technology is also changing men's lives. VASER is now being used to treat an embarrassing problem known as gynecomastia, which affects one in every 18 men. The ultrasonic wand allows surgeons to work very precisely through a tiny incision to remove excess fat and breast tissue, with a quicker recovery time to get rid of something that's really tough to get rid of.
Please welcome Dr. John Millard. He's a leading cosmetic surgeon in this field right here in Denver. And David, that's the patient you saw undergoing the gynecomastia surgery. And David, thank you for being here. Dr. Millard, thank you as well.
Thank you, John.
Now, let's start with you. Now, this is something that's been with you for a while.
Right.
And you've tried other techniques to try and get rid of?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What have you done before that
exercise,
hasn't worked?
Dieting, things like that. So.
Okay. And what did that mean to you, having, you know, what we call man boobs?
It really plays with your self-image and your self-confidence. And, you know, it's something that's bothered me since probably junior high or high school, and eventually it starts to play with your posture and hiding in your clothes, all sorts of things. So it's something I just wanted to get rid of.
And what made you think about the surgery? What led you to Dr. Millard? And
I'd heard of the surgery before, so I just did some research online and started going to some appointments with doctors, and it's kind of a New Year's resolution this year, too. So.
And now this is a different take on liposuction. This is the VASER.
Correct. We're using ultrasonic energy to actually not only dissolve the fat, but we can actually dissolve some of the gland along with it, the breast gland, to help dissipate this condition and give a very nice cosmetic result with very small incisions.
Now, how many men suffer from this?
You know, it increases with age. It's a source of great distress for a lot of adolescent boys and young men, but as we increase with age, our testosterone goes down, our tissue's response to some of the hormones goes down, so as we grow older, many, many more men start to have it. In fact, you could almost say a majority of men by the time they are age 60 will have some degree of fatty hypertrophy of the breast.
And, you know, this is something Ken Clark alluded to when he was introducing the whole package here, that, you know, a lot of men have this, but you're too embarrassed to either talk about it or even go to somebody to try and get something done. So at what stage did you finally say, okay, enough is enough, I'm ready to get this taken care of?
As soon as I knew that I could go have it done, I think, is just, you know, after I started researching it more.
So something that you'd had for, like, again, since you were...
Junior high, at least. Yeah.
And just over the years, it's something you wanted to get done.
Yeah.
But didn't really know how to go about it.
Right, and so now I said, do it, so.
Okay, and we have some before and after pictures right here. This is you before the surgery, and so this is what you've been dealing with since junior high school, and this is the front view of the same thing. So at a swimming pool with your shirt off, this is something
that I didn't go to pools.
Because
I didn't do that.
Okay, you were embarrassed about the whole thing.
Right.
And now we're gonna show some after pictures that shows what happens after the surgery, and again, this is the VASER liposuction that can really help very, very small incisions to get this taken care of, correct?
Very small incisions. The incisions are on the order of about 2 to 3 millimeters.
Okay.
We need one, sometimes two. Typically, we can hide the incision even in their areola, so there's almost minimal or no scarring.
And the areola being the nipples themselves.
The nipple that contracts itself.
Okay. And as far as recovery time, how long did it take for you to recover from this surgery?
It's still in process, but it's been great. I mean, it's...
And when was the surgery? How long ago?
3 weeks ago tomorrow.
So 3 weeks ago, and you're up and about and doing the things you normally do.
Oh,
and
yeah, definitely.
Everything. And how about going to a swimming pool now?
Oh, yeah, that'll happen.
Taking your shirt off, no problem?
No.
And it's one of those things, again, would you say this is life-changing? Or?
Oh, it will be. Definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
And how about people out there that have this procedure or have this condition, wanting a procedure, what would you tell them?
To look into it, definitely, and see about having it done. It can really change your mind or anything.
And this is amazing. Again, this is an amazing, life-changing procedure, and I appreciate you
Great.
Being out here.
Thank
being
you.
Brave enough to come out here with us.
Thank
and Dr.
John.
Millard, thank you very much. And for more information on the VASER process or Dr. Millard, the other things he does as well, you can just log on to our website. It's myfoxcolorado.com, and you can look under the As Seen On tab under Good Day, and you'll find out more information right there. So, Ken and Shaw.
All right, Dr. John, thank you. It's 9:47 now. If you don't get along with your in-law,